Hi there! I've got the body of a god.
Yes, I'm at Brighton Pier today. Not here, because all the other parks in the country are closed.
Yeah.
Well, partly, yeah. But, yeah, just here, because, you know, I believe this is one of the best attraction piers in the country, because not many piers in the country have a roller coaster with an inversion on.
No. Well, I don't think any of them actually, do they?
Yeah, I think, you know, this is probably the only one.
So, well, comment below if we are wrong, but I'm pretty sure it's the only one.
Yeah, these as well, I mean, that's a bit too busy at the moment.
You can see some of the rides haven't closed, it's a bit gutted. I mean, we've got the bump cars here, Dodgers.
Oh, what do you need 10 people for the turbo to be open?
Oh, man. There's barely 10 people on the pier. But yeah, I think Sizzler's closed. Did you see from Andy Romney's vlog, Coast Crazy? Big shout out to Andy Romney. But yeah, just have a little walk around. I've got one question actually for NS Coasters. What does N/S mean?
North/South.
North/South. I thought it was something like nipple slip coasters or something, man.
No, probably in my mind, it probably would have been, to be fair, when I was thinking of it, but...
To be fair, there's an open market for that, so... But yeah.
If anyone has a little comment about it, whoever wants to try and make a new name for it, let us know.
So yeah, we're just going to have a look around and wherever we get first.
Yeah, I mean, we can always do the haunted house first.
You know what? Okay. Let's do the haunted house first. So it's a horror hotel. Yeah. I believe... I got this tip from Harry Wolf Rodin. Well, fact. Fact. There's two different between a tip and a fact. But yeah, horror hotel, EOS. EOS, is that the right? Something like that, EOS. Built. I don't know.
Horror. I just don't know.
But yeah, we'll get a POV on it anyway and do a little running commentary or something. Because, you know what, it looks decent, look at this. Yeah, the exterior looks pretty damn good. I mean, you gotta consider this is built on top of a pier. Like, yeah. Look at this, you got wooden slats. Like I said, if you're a slice of ham, you'll probably drown through them gaps. So, like, what you want to do is wear baggy trainers. What's in for the horror hotel? Yes.
Thank you.
Not too sure what to expect on this one.
Oh, what? Oh.
Yeah, I'll be testing my GoPro session today. So, fingers crossed the footage comes out alright. I'm not too sure it bodes within dark areas, so let's find out.
Should be alright.
I'm expecting an airtime machine off this.
Oh,
here we go.
Woo.
Oh.
Oh God.
This opened a Hero Flamingo Landstar lift L. Not a luminescent light you find in toilets and Sainsbury's. Oh my God. Oh. Hey. Oh. Got is that Mona Lisa? Bit of Mona Lisa action on the wall. A surprise rocket.
Oh God.
Oh my God. Here we go. Oh my God.
That was fun.
It's got a few flaws to this one. It's a bit barren.
Yeah, it's a bit
Oh, strobe lighting, strobe lighting. Oh.
Hello God, it's me, Margaret.
Hello Margaret.
Hello Margaret.
Oh, at least you know slamming to the doors on this one.
Whoa.
Oh my God, the wall's coming out. Oh. Oh! Totally expect this to fly above us.
Whoa.
Oh! Oh!
Some hairy
stuff
hair
on my face.
Yeah.
Here we are.
Do a bit of TLC to be fair. That's alright.
Turn the fucker off.
Yeah, it's up, it's alright. Going backwards.
So we've just come off Horror Hotel Ghost Train. Yeah, it's alright. It's got a few stories on it, which is actually quite interesting. It's a bit similar to the one in Stoke-on-Trent, Winter Wonderland. It's alright, it's got a couple of drops on there as well. I mean, you got all of Ghost Trains have little surprise drops. A bit barren in places. So Ghost Trains go, I'd say that's pretty average. Pretty average. Obviously, I'll give it about 4 out. Well, so now we're going to hit Galaxia. You know what, I'm not going to do it. Come on, Bellboy, Star Story, I think it's 2006. Yeah, but these are quite, doing a part with the airtime on these Goroids. I mean, they're only small. They're quite enjoyable, so we'll check that out. I failed. Galaxia's broke down before we got on. So, it's going pretty well. Okay, I think we're going on. We're going on Booster, which is this huge, huge, huge Fabry Booster. You know what? I haven't been on one of these since I was about 15. So, I quite enjoy these from what I remember. Usually one you catch at the fair, so. It's pretty tall. Alright then, let's check this out. Right. Here we go. I was all like nervous about this one. It's been a while. I love the seats on this, quite comfy.
Comfy.
Come down.
Oh, just a bit tight though.
That's perfect. Yeah, that's lovely. Oh, in the crotch.
You don't need a seatbelt.
Oh, okay. I'm joking. So here we go, first thrill ride of the day. Hello. Hopefully the footage comes out all right. If not, we'll have to do it again.
Oh mate, it's gonna be cold.
Yeah. Oh, air ice is on as well, don't we? I don't know if you can see. I can turn it around. What's that?
It's going to be cold up there.
It's going to be cold, it's going to be windy, but the view is going to be amazing. Oh my days! Why are we facing the floor? What's going on? Wow, who needs that i360 on you up here? Jesus. Oh? Alright, I'm actually going. I thought we was going to let those on, but... you got quite a bit of space in these restraints. You can move about.
To be fair, it's actually really comfortable.
It's comfy, but terrifying at the same time. But find out. Scott, I love you. Right. Oh my days! It's probably what, about 115 foot up here. It's probably higher than that. Right, it makes it look higher because you're on top of the pier, which is probably... The pier is probably about 30, 40 foot up above the sea level, so you've kind of... You've got a pretty moist view.
Especially around the sea.
Yeah. I hope you're all enjoying the view on the vlog.
Can't see!
I hope you like my Janoski trainers. I need to get some new ones. Adidas.
Adidas.
Got a bit of ass added into the ad.
Adidas.
If that makes sense. Yeah, I might be trimming this down on the vlog just a bit because we're up here for about, been up here for about 2-3 minutes now.
Yeah. It wouldn't be so bad if it weren't so cold.
Oh no, I'm differing. Oh, I think we're going.
We're going.
We're going.
Why are we going that way? Oh,
hold on. Here we go. So now it's just us, a pier, and oh my god, a lot of sea underneath. This is bizarre. Oh, oh, what it is. Whoa.
Oh, fucking hell.
Woo. Get some nice sustained G forces then.
It's a bit windy.
Just a bit. Oh.
It's a bit windy.
Hey. Yeah, well, this is pretty enjoyable. It's sick.
Quite intense.
This one's a lot more forceful than the. Whoa! Oh, Jesus. I don't know if it's the wind or the actual forces on this, but it really, really pushes your head.
Oh, my legs.
Oh, my nutsack. This is. Oh, my. This is actually a lot more intense than the ones I remember. This is madness. Oh, wow. Oh my god, oh, what's that, dude? Alright. Oh, felt a bit like a top scan for a second then. I was like, whoosh. Yeah, that was pretty intense. I really enjoyed that. See, I always remember them as quite tame flat rides.
Yeah.
Oh, they finished.
What is it?
I don't know. Yeah, I enjoyed that. I think on our backseat blackout moist scale, that rates as very moist.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, just under proper moist. This is very moist. if you want to know what proper moist is, that rating's like Nemesis, Shambhala, so it's quite a high rating. It is a good flat ride.
Good
though.
Guys.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's brilliant, mate.
Brilliant. Cold, but good.
Oh, there we go.
So we've just done the booster, as you can see in the background.
Yeah.
That was really good. That was a really good boost ride, that is. It does actually pack a bit more of a punch than the standard booster, though. I don't know if they've upped the game, off perimeters. Yeah, so now we're just about to go on turbo. Pin 4 coaster opening in 96. It's got a bit of a... quite infamous, really, this one.
Oh, mate,
Turbo station, POV. Got some nice little views here. You can see, oh god, you can definitely see the banking on this. As you can tell, this is a Pin 4 coaster. The banking is a bit wild. If you've ever watched EastEnders, this one Heather and Shirley went on. And they got proper moist.
Hold tidy close to you, hold tidy, yeah? Hold. For 3 seconds. 3, 2, take your hands off, please.
What? You mad?
It's like you call a bit of restraint, yeah?
No, unless you get help.
Yeah. Here we go.
Okay, guys, have fun.
Woo! Thank you.
Right then. Turbo coaster.
Double.
You don't get too much arm room on this one. It's pretty cramped in these trains. Again, I don't know if you can see over the front of this, but we'll see what we can do.
Seagull.
Oh my god, that seagull's gonna die. Right. Alright, POV, seagull, RIP. Oh my god.
Get it then.
Here we go. Oh, Jesus. All right.
Shoulders.
A bit rough. Look at the banking on this. Oh! Oh!
Slight airtime.
Bit of airtime. Oh! know if you could tell, but we've got shook a bit. Shook quite a bit.
Right, I've got it.
The turbo coaster.
Whoa.
Mate.
Thanks, mate.
So we just come off turbo. It's pretty rough. Yeah, it's not as enjoyable as I remembered it to be honest. It's all right. I mean, like, there is a fair bit of forces, but my God, some of the profiling on the helixes are just ridiculous. I mean, you probably caught it on the POV, but just as to you go up the loop, and then there's a little turnaround, you can come down the helix, and for some reason, it's banking, and then it was like a massive no-limits fuck-up. But yeah, so that's the turbo. On the back seat rating scale, that was, I'll probably say about 5 out of 10, 6, nah, 5 out of 10. It's got to be 5 out of 10. So I'd say it's all right. There we go. That's the rating. It's all right.
It's all right.
It's all right. So that's the turbo coaster. Josh, what do you think of that beast?
Rough.
Rough. Just like all the dogs say, rough.
It's all right. It's, you know, I mean, for what it is on top of on the end of a pier, you can't really go wrong. You know what I mean? So it's got loops quite forceful. The bend after it is amazing.
Oh, yeah.
You get some good forces in there, actually.
Yeah.
I'll give it 5 out of 10.
Yeah, I mean, like Josh said, it's impressive that they've managed to build this on top of a wooden pier. It's also terrifying. When you're on it, thinking the only thing that's supporting it is this roller coaster, and underneath there's just sea and wooden supports for the pier. So technically, it's a steel wooden coaster. It's got wooden supports on the bottom. Yeah. So there we go. We've got a hybrid on Brighton Pier.
Pub POV. Go on then. Out of 10.
Yeah.
10. So we're joined by Harry from Coaster Review. How you doing, Harry?
I'm all good, thank you.
And we're back here again on this thing, but this time we're going to try and get a backseat POV because, you know, our channel's backseat back.
Proper moist. Very moist.
Very moist indeed.
Thank you.
In a bit, Harry.
See you in a bit. Thank you. Nothing better than slack.
It's in a drone.
Here we go. We get some ejector air time.
Right, I'm going to try and do me and you the whole through.
Alright, let's do it. Oh my God, it's going to be.
Oh God!
Alright, that's rough. That's a lot rougher than it was before.
No!
That is very rough.
Help!
My neck. I'm going to crick in the neck. I think I've got whiplash. That was a bit rough.
Mate, my head.
Proper moist.
So the rain's come and we just come off turbo and now I feel a bit battered. So now we're going to try. Crazy mess.
Oh God. Go on then.
Oh, it's so cramped. Oh God, get on. Right. Sorry guys. I'm trying to...
Me and Chris are currently cuddling.
Alright, hold on.
You got it?
Yep, that's the one.
I
got it.
Yeah.
Right. Backseat blackout tips thingy. Grab the belt on
before your bar goes down.
Yeah. POV. Oh, so had a big drip of water from the. I don't get this. They always. Why is it banked so awkwardly that bit? So,
yeah, I don't get that. Here we are on Crazy Mouse.
We're gonna get crazy.
Take a photo. It looks really nice.
seagull, actually. Oh, the seagull on the track. We had a seagull on the track the first time.
Well,
that's crazy.
It's raining. As you can put,
oh, it's raining and windy. Oh, yes.
Come on, man.
Alright, Harry. Oh. Why do we do this?
We love it.
At least we could class this as a new cred. Oh, I haven't done this one yet. Oh. 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 Oh, seagull.
Seagull.
Oh. Oh,
air time.
Oh, that was surprise.
Tough,
anyone want for the log through? No. Oh. Oh. Yep. Oh.
Whoa.
Oh. Oh. Not as strong as the Winter Wonderland spin, but comes around and corners quite quick. Whoa. Oh, here we go.
Spin it.
Good spin.
Oh.
Uh-oh. Fair time.
Shambhala. Oh. I hit the brakes on this. It's a bit. Ooh! It wasn't too bad.
Crazy mouse. It wasn't as strong as the usual Revicon spinning mouse. I don't know if it was just that time we went on. But the spin was pretty weak. To be fair, it was enjoyable. It was a pretty standard spinning mouse experience, I suppose. On a moist scale, it's alright. Actually,
it's alright.
If I've got turbos, it's alright. I'll be semi-dry. It's a standard spinning mode, what can you say? But what we've got here, we've got the shells to the turbo coasters
trains here, so this is a good sight. As you can tell, they're very, very small, compact, and if you want leg room, then I'd recommend not going on it.
Nah, it's all right. So we're going on a little VIP tour here. This is the Flume, Wald River. And it's a bit dry today. It's not very moist. Well, if enough rain comes down, it might start operating because it's bust. Oh yeah. I'll show you all seagull enthusiasts, but yeah. There's Wald River in its dry state at the moment. Yeah, shame we couldn't get on it, man. I could do with a good moisting today. But
I think we all could.
Yeah.
Moisting.
Sneak peek at all the shells of the rides and maintenance areas. Yeah. Let's what are we heading to next? There we go, crazy mouse. We have a shot. Well, I'm getting a bit of a decent spin there.
Sorry, closed due to adverse weather conditions.
Make sure you don't go on this ride.
It doesn't look like it's going to be open today. Let's say that.
Yeah.
Here we go. We've got a Twizzler. We've got a Twizzler going on. Why not? Oh, I'm dizzy, man. And we've got Harry.
Loads of
uploads
in the
moon later. Oh, yeah.
Oh, are you videoing?
Oh, yeah. This should be moist.
Hands up. It's going to be intense.
50G.
50G.
Look at this leg space. It's got to be the smallest teacups I've done. Oh. Oh, here we go. Oh, wow. This is getting pretty intense. I'm holding on. Whoa. You know what? This is actually getting a lot more intense. Lean forward.
Oh my god.
This has got a good spin on this. Oh my day, Scott, you'd love this. Lateral, geez. Oh.
Well, we danced.
Yes. Having a bit of a moist time milking the cows. You know what? I think that's the most intense teacup throw I've done. Oh, we having another go? That's a good one. Oh, the mount has stopped. Better than Nemesis. Got a long cycle. Oh, you can.
Time, yeah, the second car amazing.
Ooh.
Best part of the day.
Yes.
Where are you now when I need you? Where are you now when I need you?
Your head's back,
right? I'm legit holding on tight. White knuckle. Best way to do is leaning forward. Kind of makes the spin go a bit quicker. So, backseat blackout tips thing, lean forward. Backseat blackout tips thing. Don't have Guinness before teacups. Have we broke it? I'm broken again. I can tell.
I'm not doing
the spin. Oh, God. Oh.
That's too much.
It's finished. Oh, there we go.
POV. Coming over there. If you see it, you throw it.
Cheers, mate.
Chris broke it. Chris broke.
Official backseat breakdown rating of
1 out of 10. We all broke it. We're all fat.
You heard it there from Harry.
Yeah.
Coaster review. Anyway, I think we're going to try and do air race now. I'll flip this round so we can get it. Anyway, I did the one at Drayton Manor. Spelled by Sam Perla, is that correct?
Yeah, Sam Perla.
Sam Perla, Harry got the facts. What year?
2013. Right, so. This is a Sam Perla Air Race 6.4. The one at Drayton Manor is a Sam Perla Air Race 8.4.
Which has the four seats on the gondolas on that one. Which one? This one's only got two. Whether the experience will vary, I wonder, but the one at Drayton Manor, if you watch the Drayton Manor vlog, I thought it was alright. It wasn't amazing.
So. It wasn't amazing.
But this one might be amazing, so it's fine. Air race, you got these aeroplane rides.
What are we doing? We're gonna go and eat one of our own.
Proper moist seat. Oh my god, look at the puddle. I'll push it. Oh, here we go. I'm gonna have a really damp off.
No!
Oh, that's cold. That is cold. Oh god, that is cold.
Do not pull down your harness. It will come down automatically. Bleep, 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 bleep.
That was a file and half.
Bleep, 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 bleep. Do not pull down your harness. It will come down automatically.
There we go.
That is really cold for my mum.
It is actually. We're going to look like we've had a bit of an accident when we come off this, I think. Got the Zamperla logo down there. I don't know if you can see it. I think my knee's in the way, but they're pretty cool. You got little flight controls by the looks of it.
Wicked. Ladies and gentlemen, the show is about to begin.
Here we go.
Oh dear.
Oh dear.
Oh dear.
Whoa. Here we go. Flying like a plane.
Oh my god.
It's a bit weird in the rain. Whoa! 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 It's pretty forceful that when it comes down.
That's it, isn't it?
Yeah. You know that, this is probably a little bit more intense than what it's Drayton Manor.
It's quite
quick. It is quite quick.
This is cool.
Your legs then.
But one issue with this ride at Brighton Manor was there, it is quite nauseating. I think it's because the constant inversion, it can get a bit, quite disorientating. That is really intense, that. Whoa! Yeah, this top sword at Brighton Manor, I can tell you now. Woo! Oh, and a bit of hang time then. Oh yeah. Now backseat blackout tips thing, yeah. Don't go on this before a Guinness. Well, go on it after a Guinness, yeah.
Go on it before. That was quite good actually.
Yeah, it's alright. And to be fair, the cycle was just right. If it went on any longer, I would generally be... Yeah, Guinnessing up the vomit. Guinnessing up my words at the moment.
That's what you think about.
Yeah.
That's all you've been thinking about all day.
Yeah, but that was all right. That was, I quite like that. I think it edges slightly above the one at Drayton Manor. I think because you got the sea, you kind of feel like you are flying, which makes it quite cool. Yeah, so that one, air race, Brighton Pier. I'll say pretty moist. Pretty moist. That's a good rating for that one.
Thank you for riding with us today.
And if you know what pretty moist is, it's about 7 out of 10, so I did generally enjoy that.
That was enjoyable, that was.
Bad cycle that time.
It's quite forceful compared to the one at Drayton Manor, I thought. The one at Drayton Manor, I thought it was a bit weak. Like, I didn't feel like it wasn't...
The one at
Drayton Manor's
got a faster cycle.
Oh, no, I think the one at Drayton Manor is longer.
Something as well, which...
Thanks, mate.
Oh. I think this ride is trailer mounted.
Yeah.
So this can be used as a travelling.
Alright. There we go. So this can be used as a travelling ride, yeah, looks, which would be good to see.
Like, I'm not too sure, but the way constructed, the platform, it does look, because look just right there, it's a hold up.
Yeah.
So this is more of looks more like a travelling rather than park one.
Yeah, probably fold into the middle.
Yeah. That's what they normally do with the Tivoli remixes, orbiters. Yeah, trailer.
So trailer mounted. Might see these at your local fair one day, so keep your eye out, get on it, because it is really good.
And Harry just pointed out as well, it is a travelling ride, so if you do see this at fun fair anywhere,
No, there's no travel.
Things I do love about Brighton Pier, you've got all this view around the back behind me. So even if you're not coming to ride the rides, it is a pretty damn good view. I mean, you got the i360 tower over there. I don't know if you can see it there. It's about there.
That one there.
That one there. Yeah. That was recently installed. So it's just a basic observation tower. But to be fair, if you get on the booth seat, you get just as good as a view. It is a really good view up there. As you can tell, right behind me, there. That is the third pier. There used to be a pier there, but unfortunately that got set on fire and then it's no longer there anymore. Which is a shame. Air race is good. I've generally enjoyed air race. It's alright. I mean, like I said, I didn't like the one at Drayton Manor as much. I think it's because it might be my first time riding it and I had a lot of raving reviews about air race at Drayton Manor. Everyone was saying, oh, it's way better than Skyforce and that. And to be honest, after riding that model, it is better than Skyforce. It's got a bit more force to it, very enjoyable. But yeah, let's see what we're going next. Here we go. Carousel.
What do you want?
Go on, Noel.
You on that one.
Mate. Actually, it's not a bad idea. I'll go on this one. Oh, it's a bit wet. We'll probably be going on that afterwards. If you can see, that's Galaxia. Carousel POV.
It's all for the credit.
Oh yes.
It's all for the credit.
Josh, you're having a moist time.
Jamie! Jamie!
Yes!
Does it look like I am?
Yes. Viewers, comment below. Does it look like Josh is having a moist time? I believe so.
Oh no, look at this white knuckle ride. We'll be on the best G-force ever.
Oh yes. You can't get G-force like this on Nemesis.
Like that, mate.
Yeah. Oh, good one, Josh. Grand National man. He's on the last hurdle. Good. We're getting white knuckles from the cold temperature. It's very cold.
Chris, this is nothing compared to Derby Road.
Oh, no. If you went on Derby Road through Blackpool Pleasure Beach, you'd possibly die. And I'm not even joking about that. That's serious.
Moist.
Here we go. Oh.
I think it's time to go boost now.
Yeah.
So we've decided to go on the booster now, again, test it in the dark, cloudy rain, and after a Guinness, I presume this will be pretty revolutionary experience. Look at this for a beautiful view.
Get a good sight of the chamber,
let's
quickly
look around. Wow, look at that for a view, very nice view. That is going really quick today. What's your opinions on Fabry boosters?
They're great, I prefer them over KMG.
Yeah. Because to be fair, this one's got some punch to it, isn't it, this one?
Yeah, it's, but when we went round clockwise, if you look at it like this, if we went round clockwise, actually wasn't too bad, but we're going to try anti-clockwise now, so we're going to see, we'll give you a review when we get off, but the clockwise one is very intense, you know, you feel your head or your body weight falling down to you. It's quite a good G's actually.
Yeah. Well, what I've noticed the difference between KMG and Fabry, KMG's got a much longer cycle rather than Fabry, what's your back?
Sorry mate.
But Fabry in the way, are much more forceful, they're a lot more speed, much more forceful, they're easy to invert when you're on Fabry ones. We're on KMG, you like struggle a little bit, but Fabry, you'll just go straight away.
They'll be hopefully see France.
Say bonjour.
Yeah. They'll say bonjour to France and
Je m'appelle
Christopher. And see how this goes. Fabry booster at its best, this one.
Oh, bit of a jolt.
Oh,
man!
Airtime,
mate!
Whoa! Oh, it's cold!
Hello, Sky! Hello, family! Woo! This is really fun, man. It's really enjoyable.
Jesus!
That view is... You can't beat that view.
Feels like I want to
stay. Whoa! Oh God. Oh, top scuddy moment.
Oh, my hands are cold. I'm fucking sure.
That was enjoyable. There we go, got the trailer pate. Fabry Park. It's a bit of a...
That was the main one.
That's the one we
model,
want.
Model, Euros built. Model, that's the number of boosters built in that time from 2006.
And what about actual riders?
I'm glad you know that. But that is some good information there. Top information from Harry. Yeah. Subscribe to Coaster Review. You'll be getting more information from there.
But no videos.
No videos. You need to make some videos, man. If you can bring off... Like stuff like that in the videos, it's really good. I'm going to just get an immersive off the booster into the Walter POV. Thank you.
Are you going to leave any bags in the middle?
Oh, brilliant. Here we are. Some old fashioned waltzers.
What are we going on? This one?
Yeah.
Is that an old fashioned monster?
I'm wrong. Oh. Go on, let's see. Oh, God.
Spin. This is nuts, an old-fashioned waltzer.
This isn't nice.
This isn't your typical Jackson or Maxwell model. This is an arm. This is built 1991.
It looks old-fashioned though.
Yeah, that's just how that's just how they're designed.
It's just the style of it, I suppose.
Yeah, just look at FTS, Fair Trade Services. They do modern waltzers. They're all made out of steel, metal, aluminium, stuff like that. Same as arm, really, but it looks like they got the traditional wooden cars, which looks really nice. But this isn't a Maxwell, it's an arm. I prefer Maxwell. I grew up on them, so.
Yeah, I think we're the only riders on this one.
Yeah, I know,
yeah. Hands up.
Hey!
Hands up. Whee! Yeah. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, God, it's a bit jolty. Oh, this has got some spin on it. Oh, yeah, it does roll. Oh, God. It's actually got 40 minutes of spin. Oh, God. Jolting. No. Brilliant, that was.
Watch out, this is going to fall down.
For once, that was really good.
Oh, God.
But yeah, for waltzers, that actually has an any manual spinners.
All right, we've got to look back later for this.
Yeah, we wouldn't do that. That's a definite reward. To me, that was a pretty moist ride, that was.
It's not your typical Maxwell. Unfortunately, it is an arm, but not a
dizzy. Oh, wow.
AGT, yeah.
Very good.
Very dizzy. Harry's not dizzy though, he's solid as a rock. But that waltzes. I mean, that was a really good waltzes. I mean, it's not constantly spinning, but in bursts, it was really, really intense.
Yeah, it looked like the operator was actually slowing it down, and then as it got to a certain point, he actually sped it up.
Yeah,
if you listen to the motors, if you listen to the motors, you could hear them slow down, then increase. But talking about motors, yeah, we kind of broke that twice. The motors.
File on many proportions from us.
As you can see, the lights are back on, so to show it is for operation. Just depends if anyone actually does want to go on it without breaking it.
And as you can see from the clown's face, he's like, you've been trolled. Yeah, we've been trolled by the teacups.
Oh, God.
Galactia in the rain. Galactia in the rain. Let's do it. See what happens. Proper noise. Get the most air time, that's not fair. Right, oh my God, we want a bit of slant. And it's a bit damp. Oh, we've got seat belts on this one. Yeah. Right, so what do you do? What kind of seat belts are these? What do you do with them? Look at this. How can we do this? What is this?
Yeah, but the thing is, alright, you want to know something about these seat belts?
Yeah.
Guess who they're made by? Yeah. IE Park.
Really?
Yeah. They have the mouse as well.
So, yeah, that'll do. Yeah. We don't need seat belts, we'll be alright.
Yeah.
Here we go, Galactia POV. Probably get some nice air time on this.
Hopefully.
Oh. Yeah. Not quite there. Oh, here we go. Oh, here we go. Oh, all right. Oh, my God. Oh, God. If I let go, I'm going to fly into you. Woo. Oh. Still?
Yeah.
How's that boots?
I think these rides are trying to tell us something.
Yeah.
Wait, you bastards.
Here we go. Lower than what's in front, that's my worry.
I'm pretty sure we've got more weight on this gondola than any other.
Oh, you can then jump. Actually, I'll down the top. Holy Connor, hopefully it'll be a bit better than that.
Like a fantasy island, you used to go clockwise and counterclockwise.
That's not fair!
Oh, here we go.
Oh, thank you. Oh, God!
Oh,
yeah, it's a bit like a bit like venom.
Keep your head back and thank you for riding with us today.
That's the question. We go back.
No, they stopped doing it because I haven't saved it.
It's alright. Oh, strapped in.
So we just come off Galaxia. It's alright.
I know that you're so tempted to say Galactica.
Oh no, yeah, it's the trouble. Galaxia. Yeah. But it hasn't got the kick. No. I think it's something to do with the weight.
Yeah, I think
because we're just three bad. Of us on
yeah.
here.
Yeah, we're
bad people. Honestly, it didn't give us much of a kick as I thought it would.
Because I was at the end.
That was alright for you, but
never me. I was at the end. We two wave logging.
Hey, I want attention.
Oh, three wave logging.
Hey. Oh, here we go.
And we got Harry, background shot, POV.
Yeah. It was alright.
As Josh said then, if you heard him. What it is now, time for Horror Hotel, ride number 3.
Enter at your own risk.
Do you really want to die?
Of today, Chris?
Me? I thought it was alright, to be honest.
Let's go with the most simplest question, really, that any vlogster says, because it's totally not a cliche. Right, what was your favourite ride at the park?
Favourite ride? I'll be honest, I think the booster topped it to me. I really enjoyed the booster.
Did you have any doubts about the booster? What was your least favourite thing about the booster? Because obviously you consider
the cycle's a bit short. I mean, the first time I did it, the cycle was... It felt a bit longer, to be honest.
Yeah, that was my issue with the booster as well. It's fast, there's a lot of force to it, but the cycle was just too short.
Yeah.
You must put on the cycle number one. Because I think with the Fairy Booster, they have three cycle choices, 1, 2, and 3.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that always changes speed whenever you change cycle. I need to double check on the control panel. But
yeah.
Yeah, it was definitely on the lower cycle, which wasn't very good.
Right then. Josh, it's been emotional.
an absolute pleasure, mate.
What's been your favourite ride of the day, then?
You know what? I actually don't know. They've all been really good, to be fair, for, like, you know, standard rides that we haven't got when the theme park season's closed. So. Probably Booster. Probably got a lot of
the
force boost, to it.
Yeah, the Booster's he's generally in good surprise.
The only problem with it, like you said, is just a cycle. It just needs to be a little bit longer. And it probably needs to go back the other way as well.
With the Booster, the first time we went on it, it was better. The second time, the cycle's a bit weaker and a bit shorter. But I think if you catch it at the right time, it can be a good ride.
I'm not too sure if the winds also slowed us down.
Don't know if the wind was with us or against us. Actually, you know what? When me and Josh went on it, it was really windy when we first went on it. It was blowing us all over the bloody place, man. I think that had something to do with it. I did actually, so on the POV, you'll probably see on the vlog when we upload it. I don't know if it's the wind or the actual set parameters. Oh, donut review. Yeah. Anyway, Harry, what was your favourite ride?
You know what? It's probably between Turbo, strangely enough, or the Waltzer.
Yeah.
See, if you go for a rough Pinfari, but the thing is, it's my first credit on there, and it's my first time on a ZL42. To be honest, it wasn't too bad. Front row was fine, apart from me banging my knee on the first drop. But apart from that, you can definitely tell it's a traditional old ride. It's a classic. It's only 1996. It's not that old, but you can definitely tell with the layout, the track, stuff like that. You can tell it's old.
Yeah. Zombie. I mean,
an oldie but goldie.
With Turbo, obviously, it's the Pinfari. Is it the ZX model?
ZL.
ZL42 model. It was a big thing in the 90s for these to pop up over the UK. It was kind of a cheap but cheerful investment, I'd probably say it is. Because, yeah. I mean, a lot of parks wanted a coaster with an inversion because back in the 90s, inversions was the thing. It was like coasters, B&M coasters popping up everywhere, like Dragon Car and 8 inversions, like, whoa, what's that? You know what I mean? We had all these popping up, so obviously all the parks and even piers, amusement piers, whatever, they wanted to jump on the bandwagon.
Well, for the size of the pier as well, they had to compromise and need to think of a ride, which is good, which would stand out. But just the size of the pier.
Yeah.
Because if you had to replace it and change it with something else, you don't really have that much option.
The footprint for Turbo is really, really impressive. To think that it's on top of this, like, I mean, all we've got here is just wooden supports in the sea, and then there's a roller coaster.
It's just a single plank. That's it.
Look at that, it's just a single plank.
You
can actually see the sea underneath here. Yeah, so if you have a slice of Wiltshire ham, you'd be pretty hot. Yeah, but anyway, we're going to call it a day now. It's been a really nice day. I mean, even just being out in the sea, it's me being a Midlander. It's not something I'll see very often, so... We'll see how the vlog goes, and we'll see you next time, and it'll most likely be, I presume, Blackpool Pleasure Beach, I believe.
Yeah. I'm not sure about it. I probably might be at Fantasy Islands, like guy in Blackpool, can't afford it.
It's too much money for me.
Yeah, it's a bit of a journey, isn't it, for me, yeah.
Well, for me, so it's only about 7 hours to get up there.
Yeah. Anyways, again, a nice little shot of the sea. And I'll do some kind of cool effect. Goodbye. Alright, I'm going to do a few shout outs. Yeah, I thought I'd do them now. We've still got a few to do. Sitting here enjoying a Guinness. Josh has got the shout outs on his screen because it'd be very awkward because we took the camera off.
Moist.
Very moist. Yeah, so I thought I'd do the shout outs in the pub. Very exciting. Right, so big shout out to Brighton Pier itself. It's been a good day so far, I've really enjoyed it. Got a good selection of rides, and it's probably my favourite amusement pier. Yeah. And a very cheeky shout out to Power Updates and Carl Robert James Todd. And of course, we've got a massive. Shout out to Josh Lung here from North/South Coasters.
Hi guys.
And we've also got, he's over here, Harry Wolf for Audien and Coast Review. Massive shout out to
Hello.
You. Right, I'll try and get through this a bit quicker. I've got to give Scott a massive shout out. A massive shout out to Scott, massive shout out to Soph, massive shout out to James Paul B.T. Mitchell, massive shout out to Mr. Josh Warby and Emily.
It's alright. It's alright. Yeah.
Proper moist.
It was okay.
It's okay. Got a massive shout out to Matty Starr. Massive shout out to, oh, we didn't know what massive shout out to, yeah, to Ali James to go back.
For a second I thought you said Ali G.
Exactly what I just thought you said. He's always Ali G to me, so it's Mr. Glover for you. And Zach Glover, you know what, Zach, Alex's brother, he does watch some of the videos, so big shout out to Zach. Andy Rumley and Coast Craze, big shout out to you.
Yeah.
Rachel Cooper, big shout out to you, of course, because that's my fiance. I've got to say.
You've got to say.
Big shout out. Big shout out to Tom Exley and Theme Park Planet. Big shout out to Mom.
Mum? Hi, Mum.
Yeah, because Mum awkwardly logged the post, so I'm going to have to give her a shout out tonight. So.
Yeah, how can you not?
Big shout out to Aaron Thomas Gray, Mr. Moist himself. Actually, I want to say congratulations to Tracy and Ben in getting married. Unfortunately, I couldn't be there. You did send us an invite. I wish we could have gone there.
Really? She didn't even send me an invite.
Well, she did mention it. She didn't invite me. I'm going to just run through these ones. A shout out to Lewis Vincent, Daniel Vesey, Crystal Lees Hill, Daniel Rayner, Rob Tina and Peter, Laura Marie Archer, Peter Anderson, Leo McKenna, Baz, Bob Bard, Thomas Pugh, Ian Mears, Laurie, Sue Aranda, coming from the Black Country, three odd site.
And a massive announcement as well, she has just become the admin for NS Coasters, and she'll be managing our Twitter account.
There we go. Massive shout out to Dory and NS Coasters, along with Josh Long and Jake Burgess. Yeah, unfortunately, he couldn't be here. Shame he couldn't be here, but very soon. Yeah, so we've got Roy Nixon, Charlie Eels, Karen Monaghan, Adam Eldred, James Anthony, Nick Frank Christensen, Alex Hatch, Jarvis Orchard, and he wanted me to give a shout out to his Instagram, so please like him. He's at Jarvy, as in J-A-R-V-Y, and Orchard, as in O-R-C-H-A-R-D. That's his Instagram, Jarvy Orchard, and Mel Mags. And one last shout out to Theme Park fans. It's growing ever so big now.
And UK
Theme Parks chat as well. Theme Parks chat, great people, great folks.
Theme Park fans.
And Theme Park fans, of course, yeah.
And the open invitation as well for my birthday at Full Park. Anyone is more than welcome to come. Anyone's more than welcome to come and join the laugh. We're going to be doing a vlog. It's like a little meet-up, really, for our channel, the first meet-up at NS Coasters. Yeah. So it'd be nice. I think it'd be nice to get everyone together.
Because it's been on for 5 minutes, I'm going to just cut this off now. Big shout out to everyone. Big shout out. I can't stop it. Oh, that's why it's smearing off.
POV.